Edelschimmel satt. Nun, sehen wir schon. Sure, what are you doing here? This is a rare occasion. You're usually out of the boat. I just finished the jobs I took over for your father, and I was reporting to the guild. I finished your law too. Ah. Some others, I guess. That reminder that you guys aren't doing too bad yourselves. I guess everything I went through to train the two of you amounted to something. See? Ah, grateful too. Oh, yes, we'll report in as well then. Right, let's see what you've got. Reported about a skier escorting the reporters. Nice. Received Eagle Eye Quarters perk. Good work, you two. How about you, Sherazad? Don't you think they've done a fine job? For a bunch of newbies, you're not an average job. You shouldn't be satisfied with that level of work. Especially you, Estelle. You're always the first to get on that high horse of yours. Okay, I get it, buddy. Great work, both of you. I'm surprised that we were able to fill the work gap left by Cassio so quickly. I don't know if we'll be able to relax for a bit now. I don't know. I can imagine that the downtime might be a bit of a drag. Well, that won't be a problem, since there are plenty of other small jobs, like patrolling roads and exterminating monsters. Been a while since I've been able to take a break. Alright, it's time for my reward. I'm going to drink until I can't drink anymore tonight. Still, Joshua, you do join me as well. Yeah, after watch you get plastered and make a fool of yourself. Ooh, so what you're saying is that you're turning down my invitation. Got a lot of nerve to do something like that to a mentor. What am I supposed to say? Yeah, drinking habits are intolerable. Because a ruckus, dance like a maniac, and try to strip in public. Agreed, it's pretty embarrassing. Shows that. So do you think you're going to take these underage kids? Come on, the alcohol is what makes things entertaining. If you're so against coming along with me, then I don't need you still. Really? Yep. Instead, I just have Joshua make up for your absence. Why me? I'm Shara. Now hold on a minute. Joshua, you're lucky you'll make a fine companion. If you're talking booze or something else behind closed doors, I'll help break you in. Break me in? Question mark? Alright, you big pervert. Joshua, are you ruling like that? It's not what you think. We've got a major problem. Yeah, close. Yeah. Said Joshua. And shows that. I'm glad to see you. Saved by the bell. Long, sir. Why aren't you in such a hurry? This is terrible. My home, disaster, it's gone. What? Alright. Calm down. Hey, Klaus, calm down. Take a deep breath and let it out. Apparently, it seems as though my home was robbed while I was out. What? That's not being calm at all, still. I had something to speak with Father Divine about, so I was over at the chapel, and when I came home, it was rather odd for no one to greet me at the door. I looked around and the rooms were in a state of great disarray. Wait, what about your wife, Adita? Don't worry, they're both fine. I found them locked up in the attic room. Yeah, it's a relief to hear. Okay, that no harm came to anyone. Don't let us anywhere, just sitting around here. We just take us to the crime scene, Mayor Bloss. Yeah, absolutely, I appreciate your cooperation. Wait for me, I'm going to. Good idea, we may be able to be of some help. Well, if you insist. Anna, we'll be at the mayor's place investigating the incident. If anything come up, just toss it on with your shoulders. I'm sure it's just relaxing at the bar anyway. Yes, I'll do that. Everyone be careful. We shall be. Jesus Christ. In heaven, fucking hell. It looks like a mess. And somebody has to clean all of that up again. Ah. Wow. This place is an absolute mess. Yeah, everything is still going well. The crooks really tore through here. I know, the safe. Look at the safe! The Zeptium, which was supposed to be given to Her Majesty the Queen, has been stolen. I'm really sorry, especially after having you go through all the trouble to bring it here. It's not you who should be apologizing, it's the crooks who are in the wrong. By the way, how are the other rooms in the house? The other rooms for the most part appear to have been left untouched. About as messy as the attic room in which my wife and Lita were locked up in. Estelle, Joshua, there's something I want you to do. Which is? I'll speak with the mayor about the incident. I want you two to check out the inside of the house. You mean like an on-site investigation? Are you sure we're up to the task? Since we're all here, splitting up would be the best way to cover the most ground, no? Alright, let's see what we can do. Proceed carefully and deliberately. Alright, Mayor Ross, how about we talk in the parlor? Sure, where to begin? An on-site investigation, huh? I'm starting to get butterflies in my stomach. How about we start from this room? And let's not forget to ask for witness statements from the other residents. Sounds like a plan. Good. Trusted the mayor to have a ton of difficult books like this. Looks like he's got some valuable antique books here as well. The criminals either had no idea about the value of the books, or probably had another goal. I will assume. This is just a clutter box, right? It's empty as well. The works log looks like it was burned off. Criminals might have used a noble gun. This place is all torn apart. Lita would probably faint if she saw this. Looks like all the books on the shelf have been scattered about the room. Seems kind of senseless to have done all of this. It does kinda seem senseless, doesn't it? The gift that we delivered to the mayor, what a queen is. Those crooks are not gonna get away with this. It doesn't look like they jimmied the door either. They must have decrypted the combination and opened it, or... But they really have cracked the combination. It's not impossible, but I imagine that it'd be difficult for anyone besides a skilled pro. My best guess is that they figured out the combination using a much simpler means. What do you mean by simpler means? Well, let's see. They could have, for example, dusted the buttons with a special powder. Powder like that would have absorptive properties, and due to its fineness, be visible to the naked eye. However, blue light were placed over it, glow. Right, and... Now, let's imagine for a minute that the mayor entered a combination with the powder present. Powder on the buttons would stick to his fingers and come off. This would be one way to know which buttons were pressed. Now, wait a minute. Wouldn't they still not know the order at which the buttons were pressed? That's not exactly the case. As the powder collected on the fingers increased, the amount taken from the buttons would decrease. In other words, the crooks could press the buttons in order starting from the least luminescent. Might be a little more difficult if they were duplicate numbers, but crooks should be able to make a pretty good guess as to what they are. That makes sense. Yeah, sure. Are you a genius or something? Yeah, it's just basic knowledge. Anyway, let's check out the buttons. Just as I thought, powder was used. Now there's no doubt in my mind that the safe was opened using the same method I just explained. Alright. But the big question is, who dusted the buttons with that powder? You know, it would have to at least be someone who visited the residence. Right, figuring out who that is going to be the tricky part. If everybody worked out how the crooks opened the safe. Yeah, but you know... This part's been tipped over. There's nothing inside. Looks like it only tipped over after being hit by something with force. Look, there's some marks on this railing. Right. And they're fresh too. Looks like something metal dug into the wood. I see. Something metal. It's strong enough to leave marks, huh? This seems like something worth jotting down in our bracer notebooks. Probably some grappling hook or something. Basically, you just throw the grappling hook up, climb up here to the balcony, I'm assuming. Are you alright, ma'am? Yes, I'm fine. Intruders went running towards us. Is there anything you noticed in particular about the intruders? They were very masked, so I wouldn't be able to tell you about any specific features. That reminds me, I'm certain the front door was locked. Locked the door just to be safe. My husband had gone to the chapel and there were just the two of us here. Wonder how in the world they got in. Oh, I know already. Looks like the intruders took off with a bunch of preserved food. I wonder if they're very hungry. Interesting, interesting. I had such a scare. I was cleaning up the attic when suddenly a bunch of masked men came barging in. Masked men, huh? It means this wasn't a one-man show. How many people were in the group? I probably guessed about 3 or 4. Oh, that reminds me. One of them was short. Might have even been a girl. I see. Think about the fact that I'm going to have to clean up that study. My head starts to spin. Get my hands on those criminals. I'm going to give them a beating next they'll never forget. Okay, so the maid is not scared. She's pissed off. Quite literally. Good. Good maid. What's this? Found a service leaf. And I think it's a bit strange for a leaf to be in a place like this. On top of that, it's not a type that grows around here. You're sharper still. This is the place where the residents were locked up. It was probably dropped by one of the criminals as they were looking everybody up. That's a key piece of material evidence, right? It is. That's a good clue. They said the door was locked at the time of the burglary, right? Doesn't look like the lock's been broken either, huh? Which means they got in another way. Doesn't look like the crooks came in through the front door. Let's check somewhere else. And since this is now playing detective, we will go the good long way, make a little save. Just to make sure that we get all the... Because that is the sort of situation where you can miss some of your BPs, your bracer points, easily. Because you overlooked something. And you of course don't want it. So what you should do is make a save, go through this, and after you finish the quest, just look up how much the actual max amount is. Might be a bit cheap, but it saves the trouble of having to go back after investing hours and hours of playing time. I had a mayor run me through all of the details. How about you two? Did you find anything? Yep, we found lots of new evidence. Alright, let's check the details one by one and see what you've come up with. First off, what were the criminals after? Pretty Demophilus Deceptium in the safe. How many of them were there? The crime was created by a lone woman? No. The group was 3 or 4 strong. Where did they get into the house from? From the terrace, of course, on the second floor. Point blank, what is the portrait of those sort of committed the crime? Well, obviously a traveler will visit us recently. It's not the citizens, obviously. Relatives of Mayor Claus? No. Obviously not. Somebody works at Amalgamine? No. No reason. If they wanted to steal the Septium, the Septium would never leave the mine. A traveler. Oh, you did a good job investigation. And it looks like I'll be able to specify who the criminals are with this information. My Claus, over the past 2 or 3 days, have you had any new faces in your study? When you put it that way, I guess there's been a number of people. That reporter from the magazine company was one. Oh, those two came to visit you too, huh? But they didn't harm or to crime. They were with us at the Esmeralda Tower. I think we can cross them off the list of suspects. I see. So, Mayor Claus, who were the others? No, the detective was only Yuzet. Aha, let's not kill ourselves here. Yeah, maybe a bit of a stretch for her to be a thief. Sure, she's a student at the Royal Academy. Criminals are always best, so they can be easily spotted. As for a school uniform, if someone put their mind to it, they could create a replica. But I'm telling you, she was a really nice girl. She was modest and courteous. Right, Joshua? I'm sorry to say this, but I completely disagree. Huh? During that time, when the mayor put the Septium into the safe, that girl's eyes lit up like a hunter's, eyeing her prey. Of course, since I had no conclusive evidence, I couldn't call her out on it. But at least to me, she didn't look like any ordinary student. You must be joking. Unbelievable. Anyway, it looks like we're going to have to ask this girl a few questions. You wouldn't happen to know where she is, would you? If I remember right, she should be staying at the hotel. But she had something about taking off from Roland sometime today. Looks like we're going to have to hurry then. Well, Joshua, let's try the hotel first. Right. Understood. Now then, it is time for us to find our little suspect. I believe something like this happened while I was away. Also personally asked that the guild conduct the investigation. Apologies for the short notice. Your assistance in this matter would be highly appreciated. Don't worry, don't worry. That is basically bread and butter for Brazers.